Good afternoon, Trevin. How are you today? You're too close to the camera. You want to back up a bit so I can see your face? Thank you very much. How was universities last week? Huh? You still on holiday? Until when? Oh, so what do you do every day? Huh? What do you do every day? That's right. Yeah, what do you do? Just sit around with your family and not do any work? Otherwise, you just take it easy at home. Oh, good for you. Enjoying your holiday. Very nice. Okay, and then have you had a chance to review what we did last time? And do you understand everything what we did? Do you have any questions about what we did last time? Please do. Okay, you find the docking, let me know, yeah? Thank you. Okay, can you type the link in the chat box so I can also access the document, please? Okay, let's go to the document together. Thank you. All right, can you read it over for me, please? Read it through. Yeah. Okay, now, you have the bullet points there, and then you have the thesis, okay, and you give the topic, okay, so in other words, you introduce the topic, okay, and then you introduce what you're going to be doing, your objectives, right, then you start writing the paragraphs, okay. Can you read the first paragraph, please? Go ahead. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, because it, no. The thing is that, okay, when you say it requires you to be an active learner, means to say that, what do you mean? Can you restate or can you reiterate what you mean by being an active learner? Okay. It's similar to the first point you mentioned. To be an active learner means to say that you have to come forward and you have to act yourself. You have to get involved. You cannot wait for other people to say, hey, come on, Shravan, what do you have to say about this? But you have to be proactive. You have to come forward and participate yourself. Do you understand? So you're online and then your teachers are there to supervise or to monitor you every time, but you have to get involved in the lessons or else you will miss out on the syllabus topics. If you have any questions, you have to raise your hand and ask the question during the revision or during the exams or during the subject. You have to know what your teacher is saying, and you have to reconfirm that by asking your own questions. Okay. If you remember from the past, when you used to come to the house and I would always ask you, do you have any questions? And when he said, no, I will give you questions for you to answer, to text and to check and make sure you understood. That was face-to-face learning. This is becoming more difficult, more challenging for you and the teachers because it is not face-to-face, but it is online learning. You understand? Okay, you have a question. Yes, you do. So you can reiterate, you can develop this some more. Okay. Firstly, there are three benefits of online learning, such as Okay, let's do this. Firstly, there are three benefits of online learning. Okay, full stop. It can test your self-discipline. Okay. Only full stop. Okay. Get rid of the word such as. Get rid of the word such as. Delete such as. Okay. Capitalize it. It tests your self-discipline. It tests your self-discipline capability. Comma. They get rid of which helps serve in a workplace. Get rid of this. Get rid of all this. Get rid of all this here. Okay. Okay. All right. Now, what I want to do here is I want to just introduce the first the three. There are three benefits of online learning. It tests one's self-discipline and capability. It teaches good time management skills and requires one to be an active learner. Okay. All right. Then you say, I would. Like to discuss, explain each one. In detail. Okay. So that's your introductory paragraph. You understand? All right? Yes. Then here, the paragraph two, you restate what you did in the second point, the first point. Okay. One can improve their self-discipline capability with online learning. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm not going to delete this. Now I'm going to continue this. How can one improve their self-discipline capability of online learning? Okay, now can you continue this paragraph? Paragraph two, but I am going to each of the points you mentioned in paragraph one in detail, okay? So can you add on to this, please? Okay. Okay. Healthy habit, what? I'm talking about studying, right? One can improve their self-discipline capabilities of online learning. For example, when one is working on a job, I'm talking about online learning, right? So in other words, if your teacher gives you a task, you have to be disciplined enough to complete the task on your own, right? So whether or not the teacher is there, you have to complete the task by the deadline. Okay. Or you can say assignment also, not a problem. However you want to put it. You can put task, you want to put assignment, you can put project, assessment. Case study. Huh? Thesis, whatever. Well, thesis, okay. Is it only when you're working on something you'll be disciplining yourself? Okay. Makes sense. How about disciplining yourself to attend classes regularly? Doesn't that also require self-discipline? Waking up on time, completing your task on time, your assignments on time. Nobody is there to tell you what you have to do. You have to be self-motivated, right? Yeah, so it's also part of self-discipline, right? Okay. Nobody is asking you or nobody is looking over you every time like they would be in school. But you have to be responsible for completing your task. And also if you're a member of a group, the group's task collectively within the given amount of time. Right? Okay, good. Yeah. So that's why you have to discipline yourself to ask the questions to the teacher and make sure that the teacher understands your question and you are getting the answers which you need to hear. But you cannot just say, oh, we're learning online and I don't really care because the teacher doesn't care either, and not be disciplined enough to accomplish the task. Okay? I'm good. Like, nobody's going to tell you to take a shower. You have to take a shower yourself because you have to discipline yourself to stay clean, right? Okay, good. No, same thing. How's it going? Okay. All right. So now let's reiterate. Okay. Okay. All right. What's the next one? Okay. Let's continue the second paragraph then. Okay. If you want to continue the first paragraph, you may. If you want to add on to the second paragraph, also you can. We can come back to the first paragraph later, also no problem. Okay, fine now. You do not need to write paragraph two. Just continue the paragraph. Just write the paragraph, okay? But you have to connect it in such a way so that they know it's another paragraph. So how are you going to, what is going to be your opening statement? Secondly, or another benefit of online learning or something. So, I mean, you have to state in such a way that they know it's a paragraph, okay? Whatever, you can say secondly, it's up to you, yeah? You can say secondly here, yes. Please do. Now continue the paragraph. Are you okay with this content, or do you want to change it around a bit? Okay, go back. No problem. Okay. Okay, complete writing it. I'll check it, yeah? How's it going? Okay. Did you finish the first paragraph?
Yeah.
How's it going? Okay. Shalvan? Hello? I don't understand this part here. Can you explain this to me? This helps boost motivation in online class and retain certain information from the teacher's class. What does this mean? I don't understand. This part here. Yeah, this part here. Yeah. What does this mean? I don't understand. This helps boost motivation in online class and retain certain information from teacher's class. All in all, studying. What does this mean? I don't understand. Can you explain this to me, please? Okay. Tell me. I'm listening. So you mean to say that, yeah, therefore, go ahead. Maybe, but I'm still a bit confused. So in other words, you're saying that it's good to wake up in the morning early so that you are motivated to study. Do you agree? Do you wake up early every morning? And does that motivate you to study? Oh. Are you sure? Are you sure? Well, if you say so. So you're trying to say here, what you're trying to say is that one should be awake early in the morning so that they are motivated the whole day to study. Okay. Okay. All right, let's continue. Final benefit of online learning is that one needs to be an active learner. How does one being an active learner become a benefit of online learning? Isn't that similar to like the first point, another benefit of being self-disciplined? Isn't that to be an active learner? Isn't that similar to being self-disciplined, don't you think? Trevin? Okay, yeah, we did that, all right. Okay, continue. Please do. Thank you. Isn't Google relying on the internet? Thank you. Okay, Trevon? All right, so those are the final, those are the benefits of online learning. Then we go into the disadvantages, right? Okay, you finish writing this and I'll check this document later, okay? So please complete writing and I will check in and we can discuss it further next week when we have our class, okay? Yes, the disadvantages, okay? Yeah? So we'll pause here for today and I'll see you next Saturday, yeah? Okay, have a good weekend. Okay, take care.